In science, sometimes big developments come in small packages. Recently, K-State researchers in the veterinary college learned how to genetically engineer the genome of rats for generating models of human diseases. Dr. Mark Weiss and his laboratory have perfected a technique using embryonic stem cells to introduce targeted genetic modifications to rats.
We're trying to build tools, trying to build models that will have broad applications. So if you're interested in neural differentiation or you're interested in the response after an injury, we're trying to come up with cell lines in animals that will teach us, help us to solve a medical mystery.
Similar methods were developed with mice over 30 years ago, but the technique has been more elusive with rats.
And so there's tons of mouse models of human disease, but the mouse is not perfect.
Lots of research goes a lot better in rats due to their size and their better similarity to human physiology. So if we can produce rats that have these modifications, we can answer questions that can't be asked in the mouse.
Creating a rat that features a favored trait is a multi-step process. Embryonic stem cells, derived from dark furred rats, are modified to carry the genes of interest, which are then injected into an albino rat blastocyst, or early-stage embryo. These blastocysts are implanted into a pseudo-pregnant rat, which then gives birth to chimeric rats that have cells derived from both dark and white fur. After these chimeric pups grow up, they are bred with another albino rat to see if the traits engineered into the embryonic stem cells are transmitted to their young.
So in this cage, we have a mom that was bred to one of the chimeric pups as an adult. So she's an albino mom. And the albino pups are pups where only the albino cells contributed. But in this one pup here, this one dark pup, this pup indicates that the embryonic stem cells contributed to the sperm. So this animal is exactly 50% embryonic stem cell derived cells and 50% the albino from its mom.
This method can be used with modified rats to study a wide variety of medical conditions.
In the case of breast cancer, for example, the BRCA gene is a main component of that disease. And so if you make a genetic modification that matches that of the human disease and introduce it back into the rat, it will carry that mutation in its offspring, and we can study the function of that gene.
So far, Dr. Weiss's lab has created four types of embryonic stem cells that are germline competent for creating modifications that can be passed on to offspring, making it one of five labs in the world to successfully do so. Also, the lab's high success rate at creating germline competent stem cells makes it one of the most efficient in the world. The lab's next goal is to produce a conditional knockout rat, missing specifically chosen traits, to better study pancreatic cancer.
We're entered a whole new phase where we can now move efficiently forward with producing rats that have modifications that are going to be useful for research, biotechnology, translational medicine. I'm super excited about it.
To learn more about stem cell research at Kansas State University, please visit the College of Veterinary Medicine website.